Welcome back to The Lead, everyone. I'm John Berman in for Jake Tapper today. So President Obama just spoke for about an hour, 53 minutes by my count, during a news conference that addressed the NSA and Edward Snowden and the cooling relationship with Russia. I'm joined now by Republican Congressman Peter King of New York. He serves on the House Homeland Security Committee. He chaired the committee until this year. Congressman King, let me play you one reform the president said he would make about the NSA. Let's listen.
So at my direction, the Department of Justice will make public the legal rationale for the government's collection activities under Section 215 of the Patriot Act.
So, Congressman King, I should tell you, your office has already sent out a statement really condemning the president's comments on the NSA. Elaborate. What was wrong with what the president said?
This is a terrible failure of leadership. This is the NSA version of the apology tour, of the Obama apology tour. This is a successful program. The NSA program is successful, and yet the president is allowing Edward Snowden, a traitor, to pull the puppet strings. This man is a traitor to our country. He's been indicted for espionage in time of war, and the president somehow feels he has to cater to him. The reason why the American people might be confused or the American people might have concerns is because for the last 2 months, since this issue has been out there, the president has been AWOL. He's been MIA, except maybe for the first day or two. Since then, he's been silent. Instead, you have Republicans like Mike Rogers out there. You have Saxby Chambliss. You have myself. You have Lindsey Graham. You have Dianne Feinstein. No president. Nobody from the administration actively defending this program. And in time of war, to be somehow setting up a task force to tell him what he should be doing, can you imagine Franklin Roosevelt or Harry Truman or Winston Churchill doing this? We're at war. And if he wants to make reforms and changes, every program we have is always susceptible to some reform. But to be silent about it and suddenly jump because Edward Snowden has revealed secrets and has put our country at risk, and somehow it's like a moral equivalency. You know, Snowden is one way of doing it. President Obama is another way of doing it. I wish he showed the same anger toward Edward Snowden as he did toward Republicans on Obamacare. I mean, there was no outrage there when he was asked, do you think he's a patriot? He goes, no, I don't think he is. What do you mean you don't think he is? This man's a traitor. He's indicted for espionage by his administration in time of war. So again, I just was, Commander-in-Chief should show much more wartime leadership than's been shown by the president on this issue on a very, very successful program.
He did say that Edward Snowden should come.
Him on, totally.
He did say that Edward Snowden should come back to the United States and face, you know, his day in court. He is charged with three felonies there. But, sir, Congressman, right. You're essentially suggesting that the president was bullied into this press conference by Edward Snowden.
Yeah. It was started by Edward Snowden, and then the issue got out of control by a lot of hysterics in the media and by certain politicians because the president was silent for the last 2 months. Where was he? Why wasn't he out there defending his program effectively and loudly? Listen, one thing he is an excellent speaker. He should have gone on nationwide television, told exactly what this program was, not coming in now saying, well, Snowden has concerns, I have concerns, let's see if we can set up a task force to work it out. No, that's not... This is warfare going on right now, and the president has been a good leader on NSA until the program was disclosed in bits and pieces by Edward Snowden, and now he seems to be in retreat.
Congressman, he did make clear he doesn't think that the NSA has done anything wrong. He doesn't think anyone's civil liberties have actually been violated. He seems to think that the unrest out there is just over the potential that civil liberties could be violated. And in his four steps, you're criticizing for setting up this four-step plan. There's nothing in there that aggressively calls for massive changes in the surveillance program. Yes, he is calling for an outside review. There's no guarantee he'll implement anything that review says.
When a president is under siege for carrying out a program which is defending our nation in time of war, he should be aggressively defending it, not saying he's going to be setting up a task force, not talking about making this reform or that reform, and talking about Snowden, for the most part, as if he just has a rival way of getting out, a different way than the president of reforming it. Like, they're both reformers. Snowden went a little too far, and that's why he's been charged with crimes. He didn't even say espionage. He didn't even say how serious the crime is. And I just think this was a failure of leadership. I can't imagine a Franklin Roosevelt, a Harry Truman, a John Kennedy, a Dwight Eisenhower doing this in time of war.
Let me shift to a second to some domestic policy here. The president was also asked about health care, Obamacare, and Republican opposition to it, continued Republican opposition. Let me play part of what the president said.
My friends in the other party have made the idea of preventing these people from getting health care their holy grail, their number one priority, the one unifying principle in the Republican Party at the moment is making sure that 30 million people don't have health care.
So the president suggested your party's one unifying principle is repealing Obamacare. Is that a fair statement, first of all? And then let me ask you, do you think that the effort to repeal Obamacare is a waste of time?
No, I believe we should be attempting to repeal Obamacare. But let me make it clear. I don't believe, because I think one of the questions was about shutting down the government over the debt ceiling or whatever. I do not believe the Republican Party should be using the threat of shutting down the government as a way to repeal Obamacare. Obamacare was passed. I'm opposed to it. We should try to repeal it. The president won the last election. We shouldn't be doing something by the back door that we couldn't get through the front door. So I think we should continue our efforts to repeal it, but we should do it in a direct way and not do it by holding a gun on the debt ceiling. So to that extent, I agree with the president. But on the other hand, I am strongly opposed to Obamacare.
All right, Congressman Peter King from the Homeland Security Committee, former chairman of that committee. Thank you so much for being with us. Appreciate it, sir. Up next, more of the president's